हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर पीताम्बर हुमने, फाउंडर बॉटनी फॉर यू एंड वर्किंग एज प्रोफेसर एंड हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी धरमपेट एमपी देव मेमोरियल साइंस कॉलेज नागपुर महाराष्ट्र इंडिया. आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ लाइफ साइंसेज बॉटनी फॉर यू. फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर न्यू और नॉट एट सब्सक्राइब्ड अवर यूट्यूब चैनल देन काइंडली लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर यूट्यूब चैनल बॉटनी फॉर यू. And also press bell icon for the alerts of every lecture to be uploaded on different life sciences titles. If you want to associate with us through the Telegram group, then the link is given in the description. Through that, you can join the Telegram group and take the advantage of the different career opportunities in life sciences in India and abroad, and also the assistance of literature in the form of PDF. Friends, in our earlier classes, we have completed the 20 different lectures on plant physiology and 3 different lectures on MCQ type of the questions in plant physiology. In our last lectures, we have completed the different topics of the photosynthesis, and today we will undertake the 4th lecture on MCQs in plant physiology, and that is on the photosynthesis. So let's see today's topic, that is MCQ type of the questions based on photosynthesis. The first question, that is the photosynthesis is process. Now we have the option, that is the anabolic process, catabolic process, amphibolic process, and none of the above. So if you see, the anabolic means the preparation of the complex organic compounds, that is the anabolic process, and use of these products or these complex organic compounds for the formation of energy, and that is the catabolic process. So if you want the confirmation in these two words, that is anabolic and the catabolic, so to avoid this confusion, just you have to remember the A in ABCD and C. So A will be the first and C will be the latter. So you can just consider that the anabolic will be the first and catabolic will be the latter. So first of all, we must have the organic compounds for the formation of the energy. So formation of the organic compound will be the anabolic, and the formation of the energy from it, and that will be the catabolic. So if you see the photosynthesis process, in photosynthesis there is a formation of organic compounds, and that is the C6H12O6. So this is the component or the product which is formed in the form of the hexose sugar in the photosynthesis, and hence the answer becomes anabolic process. Then the end product of photosynthesis are, earlier we have seen the reaction, that is the 6 time CO2 plus 12 time H2O in presence of sunlight or the light and chlorophyll, there is formation of C6, H12 and O6 plus 6 time H2O plus 6 times O2, that is 6 molecules of the water and 6 molecules of the oxygen. So here these are the different products which are formed during the photosynthesis, and hence out of that, here this is a hexose sugar, and in addition to that there is evolution of the oxygen, and hence oxygen and hexose sugar become the answer for this question. Then which of the following is not required for photosynthesis? If you see this complete process of the photosynthesis, there is need of the carbon dioxide, need of the water, light and the chlorophyll. So the carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and the chlorophyll, so here not required, and hence none of the above will be the answer for this question, as the A, B and the C are required for the process of the photosynthesis. Then in photosynthesis, the light energy is converted into, earlier we have seen, in the process of the photosynthesis, after absorption of the radiant energy, it is converted into the assimilatory power, and that is ATP and NADPH2. So it means that here this is the form of the energy and which is considered as a chemical energy, and hence here the photosynthesis the light energy will be converted into the chemical energy. Then photosynthetic pigments are found in chloroplast in the form of pigment protein complexes, chiefly in, we have seen the different photosynthetic apparatus, and in which we have seen the chloroplast, and in the chloroplast there are the presence of the grana, and in this grana here there are the lamellae which are considered as a thylakoid, in which there are the presence of the different protein complexes which are responsible to absorb the sunlight, and hence the answer for this question becomes the thylakoid. Then which of the following is not found in chloroplast? So the chlorophyll, phycovalens, bacteriochlorophyll and the carotenoids. Out of that, the bacteriochlorophyll is found in the bacteria, and bacteria is a prokaryotic organism in which that cell organelles are found to be absent, and hence the chloroplasts are not present in such a type of the organism, or such a pigments are not present in the chloroplast, and hence C is the correct answer for this question, as it is not found in the chloroplast. Then molecular formula of chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B respectively is, earlier we have seen the difference in between these two, that in the chlorophyll A there are the presence of 55 carbon, then 72 hydrogen, 5 oxygen and 4 nitrogen and central 1 magnesium. And in the chlorophyll B, there are the 55 carbon, 70 hydrogen, 6 oxygen, 4 nitrogen and centrally placed magnesium in the head of the structure. And hence B is the correct answer for this question. Then pheophytin is a chlorophyll in which the central magnesium atom is replaced by. If you compare the structure of the pheophytin to that of the chlorophyll, hence here the magnesium is replaced by the oxygen, and hence the oxygen will be the correct answer. In algae and higher plants, the photosynthetic pigments absorb light energy in. If you see the green plants which are responsible for the absorption of the light for the process of the photosynthesis, then they are absorbing this light from the visible spectrum, and hence the visible part of the spectrum become the answer for this question. Then accessory antenna pigments absorb and transfer energy too. Whenever we are talking about the antenna pigments, it is called to the different pigments except the chlorophyll A, means chlorophyll B, C, D, E, F. So these are different pigments, that is again the carotenoids and the phycobilins. So these are considered as a antenna pigment except the chlorophyll A, because the chlorophyll A is a reaction center, and hence all these absorb the light energy and transfer it to the chlorophyll A, and hence the A is correct answer for this question. Then which of the following pigments do not absorb light energy in green parts of the spectrum? So here the phycocyanin, earlier we have seen that the phycobilins, which are categorized into the three different classes, that is the phycoerythrin, then phycocyanin and allophycocyanin. So out of that, here the phycocyanin are not responsible for the absorption of the green part of the spectrum, and hence it is the correct answer. Then which of the following has more energy per photon of the light? If you see the energy content of the red light, blue light, ultraviolet light and the infrared light, then the maximum amount of the energy is present in the ultraviolet light. Then the number of oxygen molecules released per photon of light in photosynthesis is called as, this is known as quantum yield, and hence here B will be the correct answer. A plot of intensity rate of photosynthesis as a function of different wavelength of light is called as. So when we are drawing a such a type of the plot with respect to the wavelength of light and the rate of the photosynthesis, then such a type of the plot is known as the action spectrum. The red drop and emergence enhancement effect have been instrumental in the discovery of. Earlier we have seen that if we have to use a light of the wavelength up to the 680 nm wavelength, then above the 680 and the combination of both. So in such a cases there is an increase in the rate of the photosynthesis of the combination of the two different separately used wavelength of the light, and this increase in the rate, that is known as the enhancement effect. But at the same time, when the wavelength of light increases beyond the 680 nm wavelength of the light, then there is a sudden fall or the decrease in the rate of the photosynthesis, and the wavelength beyond the 680 nm, that is known as the red zone of the spectrum, and that is known as the red drop. So this is because here there is an involvement of the PS1 and the PS2, that is the pigment system or the photosystem 1 and the photosystem 2, which are involved in absorption of the light of the different wavelength, and hence it can be cleared or confirmed that here there must be the presence of the two pigment system or the photosystem which are involved in the process of the photosynthesis, and hence here the two pigment system or the photosystem become the instrumental in the discovery behind the emergence enhancement effect and the red drop. The reaction center of pigment system 1 is, earlier we have seen the P of 700, that is the chlorophyll A pigment 700. So it is responsible to absorb the light at or below the 700 nm of the wavelength of light. So it is the reaction center for the PS1, and the P of 680 is reaction center of the PS2. But in some plants, again the reaction center, that is the pigment 690, is also found in some of the plant for the pigment system 2, and hence here the answer becomes C, that is P of 700, which is the reaction center for the pigment system 1. Then stomata are open at night in. Earlier we have seen normally the stomata are open during the day and closed during the night. Again there are the many variations in these plants, but if you see the CAM plants, that is the crassulacean acid metabolism, in which this condition is reverse, that is the stomata are open during the night and they are closed during the day. So such a type of the changes are found in the crassulacean acid metabolism, and hence C is the correct answer for this question. Then ATP synthetases are found in thylakoid membranes at those regions which are in direct contact with. So these are thylakoid membranes in which that ATP synthetases are present, and that are the stroma of the chloroplast. Then which of the following is not component of electron transport chain in chloroplast? Earlier we have seen the cyclic photophosphorylation or the cyclic electron transport, and the non-cyclic photophosphorylation or the non-cyclic electron transport chain. So in which there is an involvement of the plastoquinone and the plastocyanin and even the cytochrome B6F complex. But the ubiquinone is not present, and hence it becomes the answer for this question. The process of photosynthesis is a complicated oxidation and reduction process, because in photosynthesis there is oxidation also and reduction also, and hence A is the correct answer for this question. In photosynthesis, the ultimate source of electron is, earlier we have seen that one is a cyclic process, that is the cyclic electron transport in which there is an involvement of the PS1, while the another one, that is Z scheme, in which there is involvement of the PS2 and the PS1, and here the electron is used for the reduction of the NADP. So here this electron, when is used, then the electron is provided to the PS2 by photolysis of water, and hence here the water is a ultimate source of electron in the process of the photosynthesis. In photosynthesis, the assimilatory power is generated during this assimilatory power in the photosynthesis, which is generated, that is known as the ATP and NADPH. So if you see these two which are formed in the photosynthesis, and that is in light reaction, that is cyclic photophosphorylation and the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, and hence B is the correct answer for this question. Then photolysis of water in the photosynthesis requires the presence of, for the photolysis there is need of the manganese and the chloride ions, and hence C is the correct answer for this question. Then during non-cyclic electron transport, the photophosphorylation occurs at, if you see the difference in between the cyclic and non-cyclic, then in a cyclic either there is formation of the photophosphorylation at the one place or the two place, that is different in the different plants, while in the non-cyclic there is formation of the photophosphorylation or ATP molecule at only the one place, and again there is formation of the NADPH in the non-cyclic, but here no NADPH is formed in the cyclic, and hence here during non-cyclic electron transport there is only one place where there is a phosphorylation or the photophosphorylation, that is the formation of the ATP molecule. Then ferredoxin is a, if you see the ferredoxin and its chemical nature, then the non-hemp iron protein it is, and hence A is the correct answer for this question. Then non-cyclic electron transport and O2 evolution are inhibited by, so here if you see the chloromethyl uridine or the dichloromethyl uridine, so these are the inhibitors of the non-cyclic electron transport and the oxygen evolution in the photosynthesis. The non-cyclic electron transport in photosynthesis is also known as, earlier we have seen that in a recent investigation on the basis of the redox potential of the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, here the PS2 when evolved the electron, again it come to the PS1 and again it is eliminated by after absorption of the photon of the light. So in this way here there is a formation of Z later like structure, and hence it is known as the Z scheme. In photosynthesis, dark reaction or Blackman reaction is, so in a real sense if we see the enzymatic, it is occur in absence of light, so it is not necessary, it can occur in the absence of the light, it can occur or takes place in presence of the light also. Non-enzymatic, it is wrong one, it is enzymatic and it is independent of the light, and hence C is the correct answer. One thing you should remember here for the future, the recent investigation says that the many enzymes which are involved in the dark reactions, they are showing the better performance in presence of the light. It means that they are again light dependent, and hence here this concept in the future will again change. Then which of the following does not occur in cyclic electron transport and photophosphorylation? That is the cyclic photophosphorylation. First one, that is the photolysis of water, which is the characteristic feature of the non-cyclic and not the cyclic. Evolution of O2 is a characteristic feature of the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, and the formation of NADPH that earlier we have seen, it is also the characteristic feature of the non-cyclic photophosphorylation or the electron transport, and hence not occur, and that is all the above are not occurring in the cyclic photophosphorylation. Then main credit for investigating the sequences of dark reaction of photosynthesis goes to Nobel laureate. Earlier we have seen that the Melvin Kelvin and the Benson and other co-workers jointly work for identification of the path of the carbon assimilation, that is the photosynthesis, and for that the Melvin Kelvin was rewarded with the Nobel Prize, and hence the Melvin Kelvin become the answer for this question. Then radioactive isotope of the carbon, that is C14, was discovered by. So it was discovered by the Rubin and Camel. In dark reaction of photosynthesis, the assimilatory power, that is the NADPH and ATP, is used in. Earlier we have seen, if you see the light reaction and dark reaction, in light reaction there is formation of NADP and the ATP molecule, which is used in the dark reaction, and the NADP and the ADP, which are formed in the dark reaction, they are used in the light reaction. So in this way, if you consider the complete photosynthesis process and only the dark reaction, then during the conversion of 3-phosphoglyceric acid to 1,3-biphosphoglyceraldehyde, there is utilization of the ATP molecules for the phosphorylation of the 3-phosphoglyceric acid and for reduction of the 3-phosphoglyceric acid into 1,3-biphosphoglyceraldehyde, there is use of the NADPH, and hence B is the correct answer for this question. The Kelvin cycle is also known as, earlier in our lecture on the Kelvin cycle already given the names, the Kelvin cycle, as it's the first stable product is 3-phosphoglyceric acid. So hence it contains 3 carbon, and hence it is known as the C3 pathway. It is also known as the reductive pentose phosphate cycle and the PCR pathway, and hence all the above are different alternative names of the Kelvin cycle. The first stable product of the dark reaction, and that is nothing but the Kelvin cycle of photosynthesis, is, just we have seen, 3-phosphoglyceric acid is a first stable product of photosynthesis, and hence A is the correct answer for this question. Then which of the following sugar is not involved in Kelvin cycle? Earlier we have seen in the Kelvin cycle there is an involvement of the ribulose 5-phosphate, erythrose 4-phosphate and xylulose 5-phosphate and cetoheptulose 7-phosphate. So these are the different type of the sugars which are involved in the Kelvin cycle. So not involved, and hence none of the above become the answer for this question. As a result of photosynthesis, the hexose sugar is formed, which are often converted into sucrose and starch in. The sucrose is formed in the cytosol and the starch formed in the chloroplast, and hence A is the correct answer for this question. Even the formation of the starch, that starch sugar interconversion theory that we have seen earlier. The idea of the oxygen comes from water and not from carbon dioxide was first given by. Earlier in the reactions we have seen that 6 time CO2 plus 6 time water and forming C6H12O6 plus 6 time O2, and then modified version of this one, that is 6 time CO2 plus 12 time H2O forming the C6H12O6 plus 6 time H2O plus 6 time O2. So these 6 molecules of the oxygen are released from the water, and hence this concept was first given by the von Neumann. Then how many NADPH and ATP respectively are required for reduction of 6 carbon dioxide molecules to generate 1 molecule of the hexose sugar, that is the C6H12O6 in the photosynthesis. Earlier already we have seen the ratio is 1:1.5. So that is 1:1.5 means the 1 is NADP and the 1.5 is ATP. So the 12 molecules of the NADPH are required and the 18 molecules of the ATP are required for fixation of the 6 molecules of the carbon dioxide for the formation of 1 molecule of the hexose sugar. Then which of the following is acceptor of carbon dioxide in direct reaction of the photosynthesis? Whenever we are talking about the direct reaction, just you have to consider the Kelvin cycle, because the rest of the pathways, that is the C4 pathway and CAM pathway, if asked in the examination, that will be specifically asked. So in a Kelvin cycle, the ribulose 1,5 biphosphate is a carbon dioxide acceptor, and hence the RUBP become the answer for this question. Then C4 pathway is also known as, earlier we have seen the C4 pathway was confirmed by the Hatch and the Slack, and hence it is well known as a Hatch-Slack pathway. And the first stable product, that is the oxaloacetic acid, which is the 4 carbon compound and contain 2 carboxylic group, and hence it is known as the C4 dicarboxylic acid pathway also, and hence both A and B become the answer for this question. Then which of the following green algae were used by Melvin Kelvin in his experiments to determine sequence of reduction of photosynthesis? So the 2 different plants, that is one is the Chlorella and second one is the Cinerasmus. So these 2 plants were used by the Melvin Kelvin to find out the carbon pathway in photosynthesis. Who among the following have first reported the 4 carbon containing dicarboxylic acid, malate and aspartate were the major labeled product when sugarcane leaves were allowed to photosynthesize for short period of time in presence of the isotope of the carbon dioxide? Now if you see the discovery of the C4 pathway, the discoverer of the C4 are the Kodshak, Hart and Burr, and later on it was confirmed by Hatch and the Slack, and hence the original discoverer of this one are the Kodshak, Hart and the Burr, and hence it become now the answer. Then which of the following plants do not show Kranz anatomy? Presence of the Kranz anatomy is a characteristic feature of C4 plants. Now, if you see the wheat and the barley, these are the C3 plants. Sugarcane is C4 plants. Maize and the sorghum are the C4 plants. And the A triplex and the amaranthus are the C4 plants. So, not show the Kranz anatomy means the C3 plants, and hence the A is the correct answer for this question. Then dimorphic chloroplasts are found in the leaves of. In C4 plants, there is a two different type of the system, that the mesophyll cells and second one the bundle sheath cells. So in the mesophyll cell, there are the presence of the chloroplast of the normal size, and in bundle sheath cell, there are the presence of chloroplast of larger size and without grana. So such type of the condition is present in the C4 plants, and hence B is the correct answer for this question. Then how many carboxylation reactions occur in C4 pathway? So first of all, the carbon dioxide is absorbed by phosphoenol pyruvic acid. Later on, the phosphoenol pyruvic acid convert into oxaloacetic acid. It equilibrates with the aspartic acid and the malic acid. This malic acid later on decarboxylated into pyruvic acid and carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is absorbed by the RuBP. It means that one step of the carboxylation is the absorption of the carbon by the phosphoenol pyruvic acid, and the another one in which the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the RuBP in the Kelvin cycle. So here the two times there is a carboxylation reaction in the C4 pathway. Then how many molecules of NADPH and ATP respectively are required for fixation of one molecule of the carbon dioxide in C4 pathway? So here there is need of 2 NADPH and the 5 ATP molecules for the fixation of one molecule of the carbon dioxide in C4 pathway. Then NADPH ME type carbon pathway is found in. So if you see here, the NADP type, that is the A triplex and amaranthus, they are the NAD ME type. Then the NADP ME type and the panicum is a PCK type. So these are the different plants according to the type of pathway, and hence here the NADP ME type is a sugarcane and maize. C4 plants are more efficient photosynthetically than C3 plants, and it is because of what? So if we see the difference in between the C3 and C4 plants, in C3 plants there is a photorespiration which is responsible to waste the carbon dioxide which is absorbed in the C3 cycle. But such a type of the photorespiration is found to be absent in the C4 plants, and hence very little or no photorespiration in the C4 plants is the reason behind that the C4 plants are more efficient than the C3 plants. The rate of photosynthesis is higher in. So if you see the different lights on the basis of their absorption for the photosynthesis, the rate of the photosynthesis is highest in the white light. Then rate of the photosynthesis is greater in. So red light, infrared light, intermittent light or the continuous light. So the rate of photosynthesis is always greater in the intermittent light. Then under saturating light conditions, the concentration of atmospheric carbon dioxide at which rate of photosynthesis equals to the rate of respiration is called as. So when if you compare these two system, then you will find that the rate of photosynthesis and rate of respiration is equal. That is known as the carbon dioxide compensation point. The term that is photorespiration was coined by, so the term photorespiration was coined by the Krotkov, who is from the Canada and was working with the evolution of the carbon dioxide during the photosynthesis, or the exchange of the gases during the photosynthesis and the respiration. Then photorespiration is accomplished in, if you see the process of the photosynthesis, it initiates in the chloroplast, then transports in the peroxisomes and mitochondria, and from mitochondria again to the chloroplast. And hence all the above cell organelles are involved in the process of the photorespiration. The photorespiration is also called as, earlier we have seen, the photorespiration is known as the glycolate cycle or the C2 cycle, because the glycolic acid is a 2-carbon compound, and hence it is known as the C2 cycle also, and hence both A and B become the answer for this question. During photorespiration, one molecule of carbon dioxide and one molecule of NH3 are released in. So if you see the two molecule of the glycine convert into one molecule of the serine, and during this there is release of one molecule of the carbon dioxide and NH3. So if you see this process, it is carried out in the mitochondria. During photorespiration, the oxygen is consumed at, the oxygen is consumed in chloroplast also, in peroxisomes also, and in mitochondria also at one place each, and hence total there will be the three places in which there is a utilization of the oxygen during the photorespiration. Then photorespiration is a wasteful process, because in photorespiration there is no net conservation of energy, that is correct one. Then ATPase and the reduced coenzyme, that is the NADPH, are not formed. This is correct. Then input of energy is required to drive the process, and this is also the correct one. And hence all the above become the answer for this question. Then photorespiration is inhibited by, so if you see the complete process of the photorespiration, it is inhibited by the alpha hydroxy sulfonate, and hence B is the correct answer for this question. The photorespiration has been called as a metabolic adjunct of Kelvin cycle, and this concept was given by Hatch and the Slack, and hence C is the correct answer for this question. Then which of the following is not CAM plants? So Bryophyllum is a CAM plants, Kalanko is also a CAM plants, and Crassula is also a CAM plants, and hence not CAM, that is none of the above will be the answer for this question. Then stomata are open at night and closed during the day in. So this process is found in the Crassulacean acid metabolism plants, that is the CAM plants. The distinctive diurnal fluctuation in acidity shown by CAM plants is predominantly due to changes in amount of, so this change in the amount of, that is the malic acid in the vacuoles, and hence The A is the correct answer for this question. Approximately how many tons of carbon dioxide from air is fixed annually by Rubisco? So this is from the general knowledge question. As we are studying the plant physiology, we must know such type of the questions also. That 10 raised to power 11 tons of the carbon dioxide is fixed annually by the Rubisco. Then the substrate for the ribulose biphosphate carboxylase or oxygenase is, so it will be the ribulose 1,5 biphosphate, and that is the RUBP. By far the most abundant protein on the earth is, as we have seen, that there is a 10 raised to power 11 tons of the carbon dioxide is fixed by the Rubisco, and hence the Rubisco is the most abundant protein on the earth. The idea of Z-scheme, that is the non-cyclic photophosphorylation in photosynthesis, was first given by, so this was first proposed or given by the Hill and the Bendall. The activity of which of the following Kelvin cycle enzymes is not completely independent of light? Earlier I have already told you, though we are considering that it is a dark reaction, but many enzymes which are involved in the dark reaction, they showing the response to the light also. So the Rubisco 3-phosphoglycerol dehydrogenase, then the ribulose 1,5 kinase, then fructose 1,6 biphosphatase, cetoheptulose 1,7 biphosphatase. So all these are involved in showing their relation to that of the light. So hence all the above become the answer for this question. Then Kelvin cycle completed in stages. So earlier we have seen that here the carboxylation, then reduction and regeneration. So these are the three different stages in the Kelvin cycle in which it completed. So first stage, second stage and the third stage, and hence three stages become the answer for this question. Then which of the following herbicide are analogies of the plastoquinone in non-cyclic electron transport or the photophosphorylation? So the diuron is also the analogy to the plastoquinone. Then atrazine is also an analogy to the plastoquinone, but not the paraquat, and hence both A and B become the answer for this question. Which part of chlorophyll A absorb light energy? Earlier we have seen that the head and porphyrin head or the rings which are responsible for the formation of the head of the chlorophyll, and there is a presence of tail or the phytol tail, of which the head part of the chlorophyll is involved in absorption of the water, and hence the magnesium porphyrin head is involved in absorption of the light. Then which of the following lacks phytol tail? Earlier in the photosynthetic apparatus we have seen the absence of the phytol tail in the chlorophyll C, and hence it is the answer. In carotenes of the oxygenic plants, the cyclic rings are present on either side of their molecule structure, are closed except in. Earlier we have seen that the lycopene, which is abundantly found in tomato, and in it the rings which are present at both the ends, they are open, and hence the lycopene is the correct answer for this question, while in the alpha carotene and the beta carotene, in which there are the presence of the closed rings. Then which of the following shows facultative CAM or the chrysalicin acid metabolism plant? Kalanco is a CAM plant, cacti are the CAM plants, but here when there is a scarcity of the water or there is an increase in the salt concentration, then the mesembryanthenum, the crystallinium, so it is involved in the CAM. So it shows the C3 pathway as well as the CM pathway. And hence, B is the correct answer for this question. How much carbon that is lost in photorespiration is salvaged back by the glycolate cycle associated with it? So, the 75% of the carbon is salvaged back by the glycolate cycle associated with the dark reaction. A new form of the chlorophyll called the chlorophyll F has recently been discovered by the Kim et al. In 2010 from stromatolites of, and he's from the Western Australia. So friends, thank you very much for listening this lecture completely. I am very much hopeful and confident that this lecture will be useful in preparation of your examinations, like the different competitive examinations like the JAM, and even it will be useful to the students of NEET also. If you like this lecture and if it is beneficial to you, then kindly like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel Botany for You. And also press bell icon for the alerts of every lecture to be uploaded on different life sciences titles. Thanks a lot once again, and don't forget to join our Telegram group.